comparing to the organist of the Pampu organ. Pampu organs up or of elder stages is one for you. The with communion, we need communion, okay? And as a parish priest, to be in communion. So I experience communion with Lego, living together, but also the parish pastoral council. We became almost like a bancada in that sense. Well, instead of meeting only once a week, we agreed to meet twice a month. Okay. Instead of going only once out for planning, we went out twice. It became such an, you know, a communion where I could talk freely about my concerns and my experience and my difficulties, and where I would be listened to, and where they would tell me their suggestions and their ideas. And I think also the same with youth community, where I share with you that community of Living Water, they would meet on Sundays. And there was a time when Leo left, I had 7 masses. And I had funerals and baptisms. And I was still looking forward to that evening to be with them. Just to be in communion with them, to listen to what they were doing, being inspired by them. I would always say I would have never been the priest that I am now if I did not have them as community. That's why I do believe community, we say communion, has an authority over us. But the same thing for us as we priests. Do we live in community? Is community strong? Although I must say I only have known you for 2 days here, but you are really, really a very interesting girl. The way I hear your laugh and the way you talk and relate to one another. And what I heard this morning also was very encouraging as a community. Although we priests sometimes are not used to live in community. Sometimes bishops are not used to live in community with the faculties. Let us phrase a saying of Pope Francis. By just changing the word people to priest, a bishop will sometimes go before his priest, pointing the way and keeping their hope vibrant. At other times, he will simply be in the midst of the priest with his unassuming and merciful presence. And yet other times he will have to walk after his priests, helping those who lag behind, and above all, allowing the flock to strive out new paths. I think this is the same thing that we said about priests. How are we a community, not our priest and our bishop? We are trained sometimes to be survivors. We are trained to be lone rangers. We feel more sometimes comfortable as individuals, especially because a lot of us are afraid of intimacy.
Pope Francis said,
it is sad when a priest lives only for himself, shutting himself in the safe fortress of the rectory, of the sacristy, or of the narrow group of the very faithful. We are called, on the contrary, to be pastors in the midst of the people, capable of leading a pastor of encounter and of spending time to receive and listen to all, especially the young people. To belong to community is to release ourselves from invulnerability. Leaders who are vulnerable recognize that they are fundamentally limited and incapable of doing all by themselves. We need one another. There is not such a thing as a well-rounded leader. There is such a thing as a well-rounded team. Sadly, James Mallet would say, as in too many gatherings of priests, vulnerability is the last thing you would ever witness. Vulnerability means to give up that feeling that as leaders, we need to be better. We need to be stronger. We need to be brighter than the rest of the flock we are leading. And indeed, because of clericalism, priests and nuns become the super Christians, to have the superpowers to do what ordinary Christians cannot. This results in isolation of the clergy and of immaturity of the baptized. They would say that in this isolation, the priest is not permitted to show any cracks of humanity. The culture of being set apart contributed to the sexual abuse crisis. The only way to live a healthy life, a life-giving life as a priest, is to be foremost a Christian among other Christians before being a priest for the people. When we talk about dialectical relationships, I was touched this morning how they were sharing in my group, how there were tensions, how were there differences, but that it was always towards the common good. Because I think that is very natural, the dialectical relationship, not only the theological, but the dialectical relationship. I remember that we went out in the parish council, and you know, I was used to a parish council who would say, yes, Father, yes, Father. And they would agree with almost everything I was proposing. And one day, when we went out, a young guy who has been only there in the parish council for a few months, he stood up and he said, Father Mark, why do you decide this on your own? You know, deep in me, the ground was sinking under my feet. And I was thinking, you young guy, nobody has ever questioned me on this. You are only here for a few months, and you challenge me. I had a very good parish council president who said, let's have coffee break. Then I realized how coffee break is important. And then they were there, they talked to me and they said, you know what? Don't feel you are threatened power, okay? Don't feel you are threatened. He's only asking how he can help, how he can participate. After the coffee, I said, is there anybody else who has a little bit the same, you know, questions like that? Almost everybody raised their hands. And then I realized, but God, we are moving forward. We are leaving this stage of helpers, you know, to the stage where people take up a responsibility. Pope Francis says this, you know, quote, culture of the encounter. Not the imposition of uniformity by decree or by force, but the holding together of contrasts in ways that allow for the Holy Spirit to bring the gift of unity. Overcoming every conflict by creating a new and promising synthesis. The leader resolves the conflict not by forcing the different sides to agree, but to an imposed solution, but by getting them to work together to enter a new relationship, creating the chance for a new process. The word is so nice, an encounter, a culture of the encounter. Whenever we have this kind of dialectical relationship,
then we need to remember this word.
But that's why we say when
community has authority over us, you see, we have to walk together. And Pope Francis says, walking is an art. If you are always in a hurry, we tire and cannot reach the destination of our journey. Yet if we stop and do not move, we also fail to reach our destination. Walking is precisely the art of looking to the horizon, thinking about where I want to go, and also coping with the weariness that comes from walking. The way is often hard going. It's not easy. There are days of darkness, days of failure, and some days of falling. Yet always keep this in your thoughts. Do not be afraid of failure. Do not be afraid of falling. In the art of walking, it is not falling that matters, but not staying fallen. Get up quickly, immediately, and continue to go on. And this is, but it is terrible to walk alone. For a priest, it's terrible to walk alone. Terrible and tedious. But walking in community, with friends, with co-priests, with those who love us, this helps us to arrive precisely at the destination where we must arrive. We have influence for the community, and community has authority over us.
The last one, Paul, in this story, the authority of experience or the authority of the outside world. So, saan ba lang nagaling authority ng priesthood and what builds up this authority is the way the leader or the priest engages with the outside world. Ito po, Council of Jerusalem. Alam niyo naman po kung sino nanalo sa awayan. So, there was a conflict. And who won? Or what won? The experience of the Gentile communities changed the identity of the nascent church. So, inalaw nila yung experience ng outside world, the Gentile communities, to have a final say in the decision that was made. At ano ba sa decision na iyon, kaya nag-umpisang lumabas ang nascent church from its Judaistic roots. Ano, at kaya tayo nandito ngayon, ganun ang importante yung decision ngayon. No? So, kung hindi na lang ngayon magsalita yung labas ng mundo, hindi rin magbabago yung identity ng simbahan. At baka hindi rin nakarating yung Christianismo sa atin. No? So, the authority of the Gentile Christians, yung matagalabas, may authority sa buhay natin. O yung what is happening in the world, hindi naman siya sa labas, dahil nasa loob tayo yung nangyayari sa mundo, what is happening in the world also leads us. Kaya siguro sinasabi na the signs of the times lead us. Parang yung nangyari sa Gentile communities. The signs of the times. Sabi nila, the world sets the agenda for the church. Mission shapes what it means to the church. Ika nga ni Pope Francis, I am mission. Father, paano ba yung outside world also influenced you or gave you authority or had an authority?
Really, in what we call the church means to get involved into the lives of people. In what they are concerned about. That's why Pope Francis said, as a church we are called to come out from itself and to go to the peripheries. If not, the church becomes self-referential and gets sick. The church becomes a working church that lives in itself, of itself, and for itself. That's why we have to, as church, we have to get involved into the lives of people. Their concern has, they set the agenda for the church. I remember how we were blessed in a certain sense with a lot of squatters behind our church, coming from Intramuros. And how maybe we were looking at the church as a strange body. There was something that they had no connection with. They felt it was not for them. It was for those, you know, who had influence, who had money, who had positions. And I remember how I started walking there in their shanties, and how suspicious they were about me when I was wearing a white cassock, thinking, what is this white man doing here? Why is he interested in us? The good thing came, there was a typhoon. I invited them to come and stay in our place. We had 600 people. This all of a sudden changed completely their idea about church. They found out a certain church that was interested in them, a church that was willing to reach out. And then through all the process of Imelda trying to demolish their houses, we were able to protect them. We were able to support them till in 1986. Then through the NHA, they were all given a piece of land, 1,500 families. And that is, was the beginning of their communities, really, and they became became the best of our communities. Why? Because they felt that church was interested in them, that they had a very special place in our church. Our culture of leadership, as it was said, is to lead in Damayan and Bayanihan. It's not just, okay, yes, of course, as ministers, we have to celebrate sacraments, we have to be available for people. But also as leaders of a community, we have to lead in Damayan and Bayanihan. Pope Francis says the parish should really be in contact with the homes and the lives of people, and does not become a useless structure out of touch with the people. The parish should really be in contact with the homes and the lives of people, and does not become a useless structure out of touch with the people. That's why we have to look at the signs of the times. What is God saying in our situation? Like Paul, his leadership was listening to what God was doing in this world. Leadership and social engagement is the world sets the agenda. Capacity to change as church will depend on how our parish community dialogues and engages with the world. The more inward looking we are, the less chance in the way we live church, the faster we die. Not to be an inward looking, but an outward looking church. Authority of experience means we lead in this engagement with the world. And what is so wonderful is that this mission, this being engaged with the world, is the one that also enriches the church. I have seen this dialogue, I have seen this dynamic between us. They are not just separated, we are there in the service to make God's world a better world. Let's all stand for a moment. God, our Father, we would like to thank you for giving us this great opportunity to influence the lives of people. We realize how important we are to be your witnesses. We thank you for letting us realize how important it is to have this charismatic authority, our nearness to Jesus. How important it is to have that theological and dialectical authority of living in community, being a community as priests. We thank you for realizing us that the world is your world and that we should be there to make your world a better world to live in. Father, pour out your spirit upon us. We are human. You said it's not a matter of not falling, but what is important. That if ever you fail and you fall, you have the courage and the strength to stand up. Pour out your spirit upon us. We ask this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Mm-hmm.